miracle stop. Got the miracle stop.
Tuesday night, 8 till 9. It's Bhangra in Beds, Hearts and Bucks with DJ Ritu.
Now we're going to hear a man that you know very well, but you've never heard him in this particular style before. This is Meshi from Ashara. And he's doing a real kind of housey Euro pop thing here. Theranam, unreleased yet, but from the forthcoming album by Meshi, due out very soon, titled Synchronize. As I say, forthcoming on the Movie Box label. Bollywood tracks in a row coming up back to back straight after this uninterrupted, unadulterated 1161 630 kilohertz. This is Bhangra in Beds, Hearts and Bucks for BBC Three Counties Radio. So it seems as though the world has opened up a lot more for Asian musicians, particularly British Asian ones, and it's not as much of an uphill struggle to get press coverage and you know, some kind of exposure for the music and for, you know, what artists are producing. However, it's still not easy. I mean, there's not been some big landslide victory here. You still really won't hear music by most Asian artists being played on the national radio stations like Radio 1, Radio 2, Radio 3 or Radio 4. Or with any of the big kind of pop music stations which are, say, based in London, like Virgin Radio, Capital Radio, etc. And of course these stations are enormously influential with regard to exposing music and giving your general mass public a chance to actually choose what they want to listen to and what they want to go out and buy. We still, also with the mainstream media and press, they're still although they've kind of jumped on the Asian underground thing as something that they can own, possess and support, they're extremely dismissive and ignorant of other forms of Asian music, particularly the more traditional types. And it's almost as though they can cope with, say, a drum and bass track with a sitar stuck in it, but they can't cope with... an Asian vocal. That they can't deal with.
We used to do tracks like a Bhangra track or maybe like a Hindi sort of pop track. And then when non-Asian people would hear it, like my Western friends, they would say, oh no, it's too Indian, you know, we can't handle this voice. It's, we can't handle that. It's too screechy and it's too, you know, too much.
For somebody of that kind of calibre, if somebody said to him, oh, it's too Indian, I mean, he's Indian for God's sake. You know, nobody says, oh, that's too English. I'd never say, you know, they always look at Asian music and they go, oh, it's like a curry, it's very hot. You know, when I listen to Oasis, I don't go, it sounds like fish and chips. You know, this is the kind of stupidity which you have to fight against.
France recently, and there was a headline in a newspaper called the Normandy, which actually said Nitin Sawhney, un drum and bass sauce curry. It's like brainless. It's like, how thick can you be? You know, it's like, that's what I mean. It's just you see people and it's like their perception of you is based on their lack of intelligence and lack of education.
Oh,
Bhangra. When I first approached record companies, they would say to me, as I think I told you last time before, you know, we wouldn't sign you because we don't sign Bhangra. And it's like an association straight away. Brown skin, Indian guy, Bhangra. End of story.
British don't want Asian pop stars because they can't box them off, you know what I mean? They can't put them down.
The mainstream don't support, the mainstream trivialise what we have. They may say that Madonna has Indian Mendi on her hands, or Boy George has something, which is good if they're serious.
Well, this is the oldest record shop in the whole of England.
I think one of the main reasons why Asian music hasn't worked in the mainstream is that our people haven't been educated to go to an English shop. And Asian people do like bargaining, you know? And that's why things are so cheap. They've been bargained down to the lowest possible price. You go to an Indian shop and you say, "How much is this?" And the guy says, £10. And you say, "How much is it for me?"
Asian record companies, they're just brutalizing the whole music, you know, they're killing it. It ain't gonna die though, you know. There are a lot of people out there who still love Bhangra and who appreciate good Bhangra and who will produce good Bhangra music, right? But the record companies,
many ways to measure success, I think, I'm not sure. But one of the ways that I noticed that we measure success, especially in the Asian community, is if you get into the mainstream charts, into Western music, then you're successful, you know? And I think sometimes we forget how beautiful things are, you know? Maybe it's human to look on the other side of the fence, you know, that the grass is greener over there. But definitely in the music industry, if you have a song in the charts or in the Western market, then you've made success. And I'm not sure if I agree with that, really.